Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. A bearer, a witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah. And a bearer witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his last messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him. The viewers, welcome to the best of knowledge. Many scholars have said that the best of knowledge is the knowledge that will enable you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. The knowledge that will make you fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this series, we'll be talking about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will talk about the mightiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in each episode, we'll be talking about one of Allah's exalted attributes. And we will see what is the impact of this attribute on our lives and how we should conduct ourselves in light of this attribute. And today, we'll be talking, inshallah, about the eternal life of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The eternal life of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Himself in the Quran with the name of the eternally living or the ever living. Allah ta'ala is the ever living. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم.
And on that day, the day of judgment, all the faces will be humbled before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before the ever living and the self sustaining, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone will be humbled.
وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما.
And on that day, failure is the person who will come or who will bear with him any wrongdoing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said,
وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت.
And put your trust upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ever living, the one who will never die. If he put his trust upon anyone, that person might die, that person might have any problem, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is the ever living. When you put your trust upon him, you should have a peace of mind.
وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت.
O Muhammad, put your trust upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ever living, the self-sustaining.
وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِهِ.
And glorify Him.
وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِهِ وَكَفَى بِهِ بِذُنُوبِ عِبَادِهِ وَكَفَى بِهِ بِذُنُوبِ عِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا.
And Allah Ta'ala is all aware of the actions of His slaves. So put your trust upon Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala, the ever-living. And Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala, when He described Himself in the best verse of the Qur'an, which is the verse of the chair, the kursi. That verse is the greatest verse of the book of Allah, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In that verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Himself saying,
Allah, la ilaha illa hu.
Allah, there is no God worthy of worship but Him. And then the first quality that Allah ta'ala mentioned, a matter that Allah Ta'ala mentioned is that He is the ever-living.
Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum.
Allah Ta'ala is the ever-living, the self-sustaining. Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala, His life has no beginning. His life has no end. And His life or time does not apply on His life. His life has no beginning and has no end, and time does not apply on His life.
هو الأول,
He is the first.
وهو الآخر,
and He is the last.
وهو الظاهر,
and He is the outward.
وهو الباطن,
and He is the inward.
وهو بكل شيء عليم. And he is aware of everything. And he is all aware of everything. He knows everything. سبحانه وتعالى. So Allah Ta'ala said, الحي القيوم. Allah Ta'ala is the ever-living, the self-sustaining, the one who gives life. The one who is not in need of anyone to stay alive. While everyone is in need of him to stay alive. He is the giver of life. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. He is also the self-sustaining. He sustains himself and he is not in need of anyone. But and also he sustains everyone who is existing. Allah Ta'ala sustains everyone. All of his creations are dependent on him. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. A sign of his complete and perfect life that no sleep or drowsiness or slumber overtake him. No sleep or slumber or drowsiness or unawareness overtake him. Unawareness does not apply on him. Sleep does not apply on him. Slumber does not apply on him. This benefactor, this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ever living, requires no rest and requires no sleep. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't sleep. He does not sleep. And he said as well that it doesn't befit his majesty to sleep. And then he said, Allah Ta'ala lowers the scale and he rises it. And he said that his veil is light. The veil of Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala is light. If he removes it, the countenance of his face will burn everything that his sights reach to. The countenance of his face, the rays that come out from his face will burn everything that his sight reaches to. And his sight reaches to everything. So he will burn all of his creations. Allah Ta'ala is so powerful. Allah Ta'ala is the most great. Allah Ta'ala is the ever-living. Allah Ta'ala only by lifting and removing the veil will burn all of his creations. But Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala at the same time, although many of us are rejecting him and denying him and disobeying him, Allah Ta'ala is the ever-clement. Allah Ta'ala is the all-clement, the most merciful. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. Your Lord is the all-forgiven, the one who is full of mercy. لَوْ يُؤَاخِذُهُمْ بِمَا كَسَبُوا. If he punishes them for their actions, if he takes them account of their actions, لَعَجَّلَ لَهُمُ الْعَذَابِ. He would have hastened the punishment for them. But Allah Ta'ala is the ever-clement. Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala is the ever-living, the self-sustaining. He is the ever-living and He is the giver of life. He is the one who gave us our lives. He is the one who made us alive. And we should be dutiful to Him. Without Him, we would have been nothing. Without Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala, we would have been nothing. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, أَوَلَا يَذْكُرُ الْإِنسَانِ. Can't man remember? أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِن قَبْلِ. That we have created him before. وَلَمْ يَكُ شَيْئًا. And he was nothing. Allah Ta'ala gave me the life. Allah Ta'ala brought us into this life. From his favor. And out of his favor and out of his pleasure. So we should be dutiful towards him. الله كيف تكفرون بالله. How you disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How you disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? كيف تكفرون بالله وكنتم أمواتا فأحياكم. And you were nothing. Allah ta'ala gave you life. ثم يميتكم. Then he will give you death. ثم يحييكم. Then he will give you life again. ثم إليه ترجعون. And then you will return to him for sure. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala is the ever living.
And he is the one who will never perish. He will never perish. Allah Ta'ala said, كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ Everyone on this earth will perish, will pass away. وَيَبْقَى وَجُهُ رَبِّكَ And Allah Ta'ala is the only one who will stay alive. ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ Allah Ta'ala who is full of majesty and full of glory. وَلَا تَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ And don't worship beside Allah Ta'ala any other God. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُ There is no God worthy of worship but Him. كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَا Everything will perish. Everything will pass away. Everything will go away but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُ الْحُكُمُ To Him is the command. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ I shall return to Him. How should we conduct ourselves in the light of this attribute? How should we behave in the light of this or in light of this attribute? First of all, whenever we do any action, any deed, we must do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any good deed that we do, any righteous action that we must do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because Allah ta'ala is the only one who will stay alive and everyone will die. Whenever we seek any pleasure, we should seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because Allah ta'ala is the all-living and the ever-living and everyone will die. We should be sincere in our actions. And we should seek Allah's pleasure all the time. And we should always remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who will stay alive and everyone will die. So we should seek His pleasure. And we should be sincere towards Him. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our knowledge. I ask Allah ta'ala subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our iman. And ask Allah Ta'ala to give us strength to worship Him as He likes. And inshallah Ta'ala, we'll see you again in another episode of the Best of Knowledge. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.